shall be seated in God's presence. By the grace of God, this morning I'll be ministering on the topic, intimacy with the Holy Spirit. Intimacy with the Holy Spirit. Let's turn our Bible to 2 Corinthians chapter 13, verse 14. 2 Corinthians chapter 13, verse 14. Intimacy with the Holy Spirit. May the grace of the Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all. You are not saying amen loud enough. Now, three things that the Bible said should be with us. And these are the three benefits of redemption. The first of it is the love of God. The Bible says, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son. That is the foundation of the benefit of redemption. The second of it is the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ. The grace of God that bringeth salvation has appeared unto all men. The grace, the Bible says the law came through Moses, but grace and truth came through Jesus Christ. And the third benefit of redemption is the fellowship with the Holy Spirit. The fellowship with the Holy Spirit. The fellowship with the Holy Spirit. And that's what I want to talk about this morning. Let's turn our Bible to that passage again. 2 Corinthians chapter 13, verse 14. May the grace of the Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Now, if you are here this morning, you are born again. It's because you have experienced the love of God. You have embraced the love of God. If you are here this morning, you are born again. It's because you have accepted the grace that brings salvation that Christ brought. But the next thing is, the Bible says that is not where it ends. You must enjoy the fellowship of the Holy Ghost. The reason why many believers are not living a life of fulfillment, the reason why the life of many Christians is not different from the life of unbelievers, is because we are not intimate with the Holy Ghost. Now, what is fellowship? Dictionary defines fellowship as friendly association. Fellowship is friendly association. It's not just that's what they call old boys association. People you went to the same secondary school. But anybody that is not your friend there is not in fellowship with you. You may be in the same association, but you are not in fellowship. So fellowship is friendly association. And so the word fellowship that we read in 2 Corinthians chapter 13, verse 14, is taken from the Greek word called koinonia. Koinonia, which means association, friendship, partnership, sharing, communion, and intimacy. Koinonia means association, friendship, partnership, sharing, communion, and intimacy. And that's what fellowship means. Now, many of us know about God, and many of us know about Jesus. I'm assuming that we know it, but many don't know about the Holy Ghost. To some of us, Holy Ghost is an angel. The reason why so many Christians are living substandard life is because they don't know the Holy Ghost. Without the knowledge of the Holy Ghost, you cannot live a life of fulfillment. And that's why this morning I want to talk about intimacy with the Holy Spirit. And so that passage in 2 Corinthians chapter 13, verse 14, If I'm going to read it with this understanding, it will read this way. May the grace of the Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the fellowship, the koinonia, the association, the friendship, the partnership, the sharing, the communion, and the intimacy of the Holy Ghost be with you all. And so the question is, does this represent the kind of relationship you have with the Holy Ghost? And if this does not represent the kind of fellowship you have with the Holy Ghost, you cannot enjoy the full benefit of redemption. We are substandard believers without proofs in their life today, because many don't understand the place of the Holy Spirit in their life. John chapter 16, verse 17. Let's see what Jesus said. Nevertheless, I tell you the truth. It is to your advantage that I go away. Who was talking here? Jesus said it is to whose advantage? It is to your advantage that I go away. For if I do not go away, the helper will not come to you. But if I go, I will send him to you. Now Jesus said it is to your advantage that he goes away. And Jesus has to go to heaven for the helper to come. And he said, when I go away, I, Jesus, will send the helper to you. Now one of the reasons why many of us are not enjoying the fellowship of the Holy Spirit is because we are not helpless. You know how to fix your things. When you don't know money, have money, you know who to call and borrow money from. You don't need help. When you are sick, you know the medicine to take. When you are in a difficult situation, you know who to call. When you are having problems in your marriage, you have your way of resolving it. So you don't need help. But the Bible says the Holy Ghost is helper. Helper only comes to people who need help. But because many of us have decided to run our life our own way, therefore the Holy Ghost cannot come and take charge. God knows that you are helpless. And that's why he sent the Holy Ghost. When the Pharisees were confronting Jesus, that why are you dining with sinners? Jesus said, he that is not sick does not need physician. You Pharisees, because you think you are okay, then you don't need me. And that is the same way many are in the church today. The Holy Ghost has no impact in their life because they know how to fix their problem. So if you want to enjoy the fellowship of the Holy Ghost, you must realize that you are helpless and you need his help. If you know how to fix it, then the Holy Ghost is not required. Can you give me another translation of that same verse? Okay. But I tell you, I am going to do what is the best for you. I'm going to do what is best for you. Now, the Bible is saying, Jesus is talking here that I'm going to do what is best for you. And what is that thing that is best for you? This way, I am going away. This is why I'm going away. The Holy Spirit cannot come to help you unless I leave. But after I'm gone, I will send the Spirit to you. Jesus said, the Holy Spirit cannot come to help you. Can you come and help somebody that does not need help? So if you want the Holy Spirit to help you, you must realize that you are helpless. Many of us know how to fix our problem. And I want to let you know this morning that before the Holy Ghost, you don't know how to do anything. Even prayer, you don't know how to pray. All this labashatarabata, you are saying, is nothing before the Holy Spirit. You don't know how to pray. The Bible says we do not know how to pray as we ought to.
But the Holy Spirit makes intercession for through groaning that cannot be uttered. Before Holy Ghost, you don't know anything. And until when you get to a level that you don't know anything, the Holy Ghost cannot take over the affairs of your life. If you know how to run your marriage, continue to run it. That's why you are running into crisis. If you know the best way to run your career, continue to run it. That's why you are running into crisis. Promotion is not coming because you are doing this your own way. If you know how to run your business, continue to do it that way. And that is why your business is not profitable with all the effort. Because the Holy Ghost will never come and help somebody that knows how to do it. He that is not sick does not need physician. Can you give me another translation in Message version? So let me say it again, this truth. In case you have forgotten what you have said before. It's better for you that I leave. If I don't leave, the friend won't come. Who is Jesus calling the friend? But if I go, I will send him. And so if Holy Spirit is your friend, when last did you talk to him? To some of us, Holy Ghost is like a GPRS. You use it when you don't know the way. When you are looking for a husband, you'll be praying, Holy Spirit, please talk to me. But when last did you ask him to talk to you? If you have a friend that you only call when you are in need, is that a friend? If somebody is calling him your friend for the last 6 months, he will pass through in front of your eye, will not even greet you. But anytime he needs some coins, he will come and knock your door. Ah, my friend, can you borrow me money? One day you tell, don't stop deceiving me. Am I your friend? You only come where you need me. And that's how many people run into crisis in life because they have turned the Holy Ghost to GPRS. The Holy Ghost, you have not consulted all this while. When you want to marry, you want him to talk to you. Jesus said, Holy Spirit is your friend. And because it's your friend, that's why the Bible is talking about fellowship with the Holy Spirit, communion, communication with the Holy Spirit. Some of us are not even conscious of him. Is he not somebody you are conscious of that you are going to talk with? You don't even recognize that the Holy Spirit is in you. Because everybody that is born again has the Holy Spirit in him. Because without the Holy Spirit, you cannot even be born again. The Bible says it's the seal of our salvation. I'm not talking about Holy Ghost baptism here. The Holy Ghost baptism is the Spirit upon. The empowerment from above. It comes to empower you. But when you give your life to Jesus Christ, the Holy Spirit comes into you to bear the fruit of the Spirit. And to guide you. And so even a day-old believer can communicate with the Holy Spirit for guidance. But many of you are not even conscious that you have the Holy Ghost within you. And when you are not conscious, how can you have fellowship with him? No wonder many lives are not producing results. No wonder many believers, their lives have become a mockery among unbelievers. Because there is no proof, there is nothing to show that something is working for you. And yet you cannot get the full benefit of redemption until when you are in intimacy with the Holy Ghost. Is somebody with me this morning? Are you sure you are with me this morning? In John chapter 16, verse 3 to 15. John 16, 3 to 15. Now, I want you to pay attention to this scripture. Jesus said, "Howbeit, when he, the Spirit of truth, is come, he will guide you into what? Into what? The Bible did not say we guide you into truth. It said we guide you into all truth. Absolute.
There is a truth about your marriage. There is the truth about your career. There is the truth about the decision you are supposed to take at time. Jesus said the reason why the Holy Spirit is coming is to guide you into all truth. Many are entering into errors because the Holy Spirit are not guiding them. There are needless problems in people's life because the Holy Spirit are not guiding them. The Holy Spirit has not come to guide you into some of the truth. He has come to guide you into all truth. I want you to listen to this. The Bible says, in all your ways, in Proverbs chapter 3, it says, in all your ways, acknowledge him and he will direct your path. Did the Bible say in some of your ways? Did the Bible say, acknowledge God in so, when it is time to marry, acknowledge God and then God will direct you in the time of marriage? And you can choose not to acknowledge him in any other way. He said, in all your ways. Many will say, oh, but I ask God, Holy Ghost, to direct me when I want to marry. Why did I marry this devil? The scripture is, in all your way, acknowledge him, and he will direct your path. Holy Ghost is not a tool that you pick up when you want to use. Holy Ghost is not a dictionary that you look for when you are looking for meanings of difficult words. Holy Ghost is not a GPRA that you only consult when few times that you don't know your way to your destination. The scripture is, in all your ways, acknowledge him, and he will direct your path. And so if you don't acknowledge the Holy Ghost in all your ways, don't expect him to direct you when you acknowledge him in some of your way, because the scriptures cannot be broken. Are you understanding what I'm saying this morning? The Bible says there is a way that seemeth right to a man. Even the one that you think is right may be wrong. And so if you say, I know the way to my office now. I know the best way to go is to go through ferry so that I can get there on time. That is the way that seemed right. But some people took it and they die on the way. Is it not to go through Tom Mainland? Why do I need to tell the Holy Ghost, guide me this morning as I'm going to office? Why do I need his guidance when I know the way? But many people have gone through Tom Mainland and they didn't come back again. The Bible says there is a way that seemeth right to a man, but the end thereof leads to destruction. And that's why the scripture says, in all your ways, nothing is too small to tell the Holy Spirit. You want to go have a conversation with somebody? Holy Spirit, please help me. Jesus said, when you get before the judge, don't think about what to say. He said, at that moment, the Holy Spirit will give you what to say. You go for interview, you only prepare, and you think it takes preparation alone to get the job. There are many people that are better prepared than you, and they are still jobless today. But when the Holy Spirit gives you the right word, then the deal is done. In all your ways, acknowledge him, and he will direct your path. Intimacy with the Holy Ghost. Fellowship with the Holy Ghost. Now give me that scripture again. Howbeit, when he, the Spirit of truth, is come, he will guide you into all truth. For he shall not speak of himself. I don't want you to miss this part. Jesus said, the Holy Spirit, many of you don't even know this. Jesus said, the Holy Spirit will not speak of himself. How does he speak? But whatsoever he shall hear, that shall he speak. Who is the Holy Spirit hearing for? And he will show you things to come. The reason why you don't know things to come, the reason why things happen to you by accident, the reason why you don't take the right step in life, is because you are not in deep fellowship. You are not in intimacy with the Holy Ghost. You are the one who is losing. Because Jesus said it is for your advantage. And when you refuse to have fellowship with him, it is to your disadvantage. There are many believers. The believers that are disadvantaged are much more than those that are advantaged. And yet we have the same privilege. We have the same Bible. But many of us are forsaking the fellowship with the Holy Spirit. Give me that passage again. Now he said, he shall glorify me, for he shall receive of mine.
and shall show unto you. Who is the Holy Ghost going to receive from? From who? From who? See, okay, God, Jesus. Who is talking here? Okay, when we say God, Jesus is God too. So that is God the Father. That is God the Son. That is God the Holy Spirit. So if you are saying God, tell me God the Son. Don't just say God. Because when you say God, it could be God the Father, it could be God the Son, it could be God the Holy Spirit. And that's why when you pray, you don't say in the name of God. You say in the name Father. You call God your Father because you have relationship with Him. Are you understanding what I'm trying to say? When you pray, you call Him your Father and you pray in the name of Jesus. Now, Jesus was talking here. Can you give me that passage again? He shall glorify me, for he shall receive of mine, and he shall show unto you. Jesus has initially told us that he will not speak of himself. He said, whatsoever he hears, that is what he's going to say. And this is the source. The Holy Spirit, the God, the Holy Spirit, gets from this God, the Son, to give to you. Now let's see the next verse. All the things that the Father had are mine. Therefore said I, that he shall take of mine and shall show unto you. You understand this scripture? All that the Father has given to the Son. And the Holy Spirit began to take from what the Son has to begin to give to you. If you don't have it, it's not because it's not there. The problem is that you are not connected with the Holy Spirit. Because the only thing that connects you is the Holy Spirit. Jesus said, he will take from me, and I have all from the Father, and he will give to you. The Bible says, it has pleased the Father that in Jesus all fullness should dwell. And so there is a connection between the Trinity. The Father has emptied himself into the Son. The Holy Spirit takes from the Son and begin to give to you. And so how do you get from the Son unless you have fellowship with the Holy Spirit? And that's why so many lives don't have results. That's why many people are living a life of mediocrity. That's why many are Christian, but there is no proof in their life. What is happening to unbeliever, their life is no different because they have been disconnected. They have been disconnected from the source, not by God, but because they lack knowledge. The Bible says, my people perish for lack of knowledge. My people perish for lack of knowledge. Now give me verse 14 again of that same chapter. Now listen to this. Jesus said, he shall do what? Who will glory? The Holy Spirit will glorify who? Okay. And how is he going to glorify Jesus? By the things he will be doing in your life. So whatever, I want you to understand, the Holy Ghost is an helper. An helper is somebody that has come to fix a problem. So every problem of your life that will bring glory to Jesus is what Holy Ghost wants to solve. If you are having problem, challenge in the area of health, and your healing will bring glory to Jesus, that is what the Holy Ghost wants to do. If your promotion will bring glory to Jesus, that is what the Holy Ghost wants to do. If your getting married will give glory to Jesus, that is what the Holy Ghost wants to do. If your giving birth will give glory to Jesus, that's what the Holy Spirit wants to do. If you are taking the right step in life, we give glory to Jesus. That's what the Holy Ghost wants to do. And I don't know the problem you came with this morning. They say it's a terminal disease. They say there is no way for you. Somebody has told you that you cannot be promoted. Somebody has said you can't make it in life again. And when it happened for you, they will say, who did it? And when they say it is Jesus, the world will glorify Jesus. That is the reason why the Holy Ghost has come to fix those problems so that glory will be given to Jesus. And it's my prayer for you today that Jesus will be glorified here. Jesus will be glorified here. Jesus will be glorified in this meeting in the mighty name of Jesus. J John chapter 14, verse 26. John chapter 14, verse 26. But the Helper, the Holy Spirit, whom the Father will send in my name, he will teach you what? He will teach you many things. He will teach you some things. Nobody knows chemistry like the Holy Ghost. Because he's the author of knowledge. And so, a foolish student that is born again, we read chemistry, and as he's reading, we not have the Holy Ghost to help him to have understanding. Because no one can teach you the way Holy Ghost will do. And God did not send the Holy Ghost to teach you something. He sent him to teach you all things. You are in your place of what they have given you an assignment. It's something you have been doing all over again. You are already used to it. Still tell the Holy Ghost, come and help me. Because there are people that the thing they have been doing all over and over again, one day they will do it and it will not work and it will become a problem. You may even do it the way you have been doing it. Your boy will say, but this is not the way. But oh God, this is the way we've been doing it. But I said, this is not the way. But when the Holy Ghost is always working with you, when you get to that point in your life, that there is not a time you believe that you know it. Because you don't need to know it when you have somebody that knows it. Are you understanding what I'm saying this morning? Why do I need to say I know it when I know that somebody is within me that knows it better? And so I can always depend on him. If I've read my book and I'm going to the exam hall, I can depend on the creator of knowledge to give me more understanding, to do it better than what physical man can comprehend. The Bible says he will teach you all things. Not few things. Not some things. In everything you must acknowledge the Holy Ghost, because he knows it better than you do. Give me that passage again. But the Helper, the Holy Spirit, whom the Father will send in my name, he will teach you all things and bring to your remembrance what? All that I said to you. That means the Holy Spirit can bring to your remembrance all that you have heard. There are many things that we escape my memory, and I will tell Holy Spirit, can you remind me? And within some minutes, the things get back to me. You are in the exam hall. You can't remember something that you have read. The Bible says Holy Spirit will bring to remember all, not some, not few. And so if you refuse to have deep fellowship with him, God wants it, because the reason why the Bible calls it fellowship is because you will have reason to talk to him all the time. If you don't have reason to talk to Holy Ghost more than 10 times in a day, you are not in fellowship with him. Or you are, it's either you are lied down, you are tied down. You are not going anywhere, not making any progress, not doing anything. But you have activity, you go to office, you meet with people, you attend meeting, and you don't talk to the Holy Ghost up to 10 times in a day, then something is fundamentally wrong. Give me the book of John, chapter 14, verse 17. My time is up. I can't finish this. John 14, 17. John 14, 17. Even the Spirit of truth, whom the world cannot receive. Who cannot receive him? Who cannot receive the Holy Ghost? Who are the world? Eh? Okay, we. If you are born again, you are not the world. But if you have not given your life to Jesus, you are still in the world. And that's why we said this benefit of redemption, starting from the love of God,
For God so loved the world. It was the desire of God is that the world will be a beneficiary of this blessing. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, that whosoever believeth in him shall not perish but have everlasting life. Once you believe in the gift of love that God has offered, you have been translated from this world into the kingdom of his dear son. Are you understanding what I'm saying? And so when you are born again, it is only when you are born again that you can receive the Holy Ghost. The Bible says the world cannot receive him. Anyone that has not given his life to Jesus cannot receive the Holy Ghost. Only those who are born again can receive him, because he is the seal of your salvation. Can you give me that passage again? Even the Spirit of truth, whom the world cannot receive, because he seeth him not, neither knoweth him. But ye know him. But do you know him? If you don't know him, you can't receive him. And that's why I'm bringing who the Holy Spirit is to you. But ye know him, for he will dwell with you and shall be in you. I want you to understand what Jesus said Holy Ghost will do. He said he will dwell with you. So in your house, the Holy Spirit is living with you. And the Bible says he will be in you. So anywhere you are going to, the Holy Spirit is within you. And the Holy Spirit is also with you. Are you understanding what I'm saying? The Holy Spirit is within you and is around you. And if God has done it that way, and you fail to have fellowship with him, then things that are not supposed to happen will begin to happen to you. Many of you are running helter skelter, looking for one man to prophesy over your life. I've done several counseling of people that are frustrated in marriage. And now when I ask them, how did you get this man you are calling a devil today? They say one prophet said that's the person I'm going to marry. Where is the prophet today? The prophet that told you, where is the prophet today? Your life is miserable. And yet you are born. I said, why are you not born again there? And I was born again, but you know, we have to ask prophet to pray for us. You have the Holy Spirit. And you are still running after prophets. Many lives have been destroyed because people fail to have deep fellowship with the Holy Ghost. When you see a man that is in deep fellowship with the Spirit, you will see by the proofs in their life. But when your life is messed up with error, with mistake, it shows the absence of the Holy Ghost in your life. Because the Holy Spirit is a perfect spirit. Absolute perfection. He does not make any mistake. He does not commit any error. He does not commit any blunder. Shall we rise up this morning as we pray? The Bible says the world cannot receive him. The world cannot receive him. Anyone that is living in sin, sold out to sin, cannot receive the Holy Ghost. And so if you have not given your life to Jesus, this is your moment. Don't allow this moment to pass you by. I want you to say this prayer after me. Lord Jesus, I'm a sinner. I come before you this morning to repent of all my sins. I want you to forgive me. I want you to wash me clean with your blood. I want to come into my heart, Lord Jesus. Come into my heart, Lord Jesus. And give me the power to go and sin no more. In Jesus' mighty name, I pray. And Father, I pray for everyone that has said this prayer. That from today, they will begin to live in the newness of life in the mighty name of Jesus. The Holy Ghost has become the seal of their salvation. As from today, the Holy Spirit will guide you. He will guide you into all truth in the mighty name of Jesus. He will make every crooked path before you to be straightened in the mighty name of Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying. And Jesus said the Holy Ghost is the helper. He has come for the helpless. I want you to go before God today and say, God, I'm helpless. I can't do it by my power. I surrender all to you. I surrender my marriage to you. I surrender my finance to you. I surrender my career to you. I surrender the training of my children to you. I surrender, oh Lord, my thoughts, my ways unto you. I don't know what is right. You do, Lord. Because the way that seems right to a man leads to destruction. Holy Ghost, I'm helpless. Come and help me. I need help coming to my life. Take charge of my marriage. Take charge of my finance. Take charge of my ministry. Take charge of my children. Take charge of my thinking. Take charge of my planning. Take charge of my entire life. I surrender all to you, Holy Ghost. Be the Lord over my life. Guide me into all truth. Lead me in the path that we go, Holy Spirit. Speak to the Holy Ghost. Confess your inadequacy before Him. Confess your insufficiency before Him. Apostle Paul said of myself, I'm sufficient to do nothing, but my sufficiency is of God. There is absolutely nothing I know how to do, Holy Spirit. I don't know how to preach. I don't know how to talk. I don't know how to walk. But you are the one who have come to help me to do all things by your power. Confess your inadequacies, your weakness before the Holy Spirit. The Bible says, when I'm weak, then the strength of God will be made manifest in my life. Pray for the strength of God. Confess your weakness before Him today. The Holy Ghost will come and glorify Jesus. When that tumor in your body disappears, Jesus will be glorified. When that fibroid in your womb disappears, Jesus will be glorified. When that unemployment comes to an end in your life, Jesus will be glorified. Oh, when that bad pain disappears, Jesus will be glorified. When that injury in the neck disappears, Jesus will be glorified. When that toothache is gone, Jesus will be glorified. Malaba santo borokote inke derubo satumate evetu abrala gashedemo evetu meketoria like oriala gaba kashidebo maraba suba katubata. Father, we give you all the glory. We give you all the glory. We give you all the glory. Father, the moment has come for Jesus to be glorified in this place. Whatever represents need in the life of your people, you are the helper that can fix all problems, that can solve all problems. Holy Spirit, move, touch your people. Heal the sick that are here this morning. Set your oppressed free in the mighty name of Jesus. Set your oppressed free in the mighty name of Jesus. Heal the womb that is weak in the mighty name of Jesus. Break yoke, break curses in the mighty name of Jesus. Oh, let there be financial miracle in the mighty name of Jesus. Come and assist your people. You are the helper. Everybody too heavy for you to carry. The Holy Ghost is moving in now. It's moving in now. It's moving in now. Your body are lifted. Your yoke are broken. Your sickness are healed. In the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you, blessed Holy Spirit, for glorifying Jesus once again. We thank you, Lord, for in Jesus' mighty name we are praying.